compliance has not been one of ICANN's strong suits for a variety of reasons. There's been a lot of turnover in that office. It's not necessarily all that well funded. New people come and go. It's a bit of a revolving door. People have learning curves. But fundamentally, the problem with compliance at ICANN is that the contract with registrars, the registrar accreditation agreement, does not necessarily provide the most clear provisions for enforcing anything. So when you talk about enforcing rules and regulations, it's very important because the registrar accreditation agreement is really the core principle behind how ICANN functions. And by that, I mean you hear a lot of people talk about how spam is not ICANN's responsibility, and cybercrime and fraud, that, you know, that's outside ICANN's scope and all of that. That's really not true. In fact, it's baldly not true, in the sense that a lot of those kinds of problems could be addressed with proper enforcement of the Registrar Accreditation Agreement. And so one of the things that I'm doing now is I'm chairing a user working group to look at the RAA in layman's language and read through it and try to, you know, understand it and make some notes about where we think there are parts that should be tightened up, things that should be strengthened, some stuff taken out. Because traditionally, the registrars have written their own contracts. So naturally, they're written in a way that's going to be very favorable for the registrar's business. Okay, that's got to stop. That's not how a multi-stakeholder organization that's supposed to work in the public interest should function. So it's very important to pay attention as you're studying and learning about ICANN. Roll up your sleeves and get into the Registrar Accreditation Agreement, because it really is, as boring as it is, it's not that long, and it's the fundamental piece of legislation, if you will, that guides what we do.